Hi, this is Sarah from sarahtypes.com. Today I'm going to show you how to get started with the Procreate app on iPad. So the first thing we're going to look at are creating new layers and using the brushes. To create a new layer, you're going to just click on the layers icon in the top right, choose the plus button, and there's your new layer. You're automatically on your new layer, so you can click on the brush icon to use the brush tool. If you'd like to import a new brush, you can either choose to import it to a collection you already have in your scrolling window here, or you can create a new set, call it new, and then you just click on the plus on the top right, and then you can either create your own brush or you can import by clicking import. There's a few places you can choose from. You can upload files to the Procreate app using iTunes, or you can import from a cloud storage. So that's what I'm going to do. I'm going to actually import and then choose locations and click Dropbox. I have a folder in Dropbox called Brushes, and here I save all the brushes I've downloaded just so I can keep them there in case anything happens to my Procreate app. I have a backup. So I'm just going to select one of these, and it's going to go into that folder right there. So it's a splatter light flex brush. It's more of a texture brush. You can change the size of the brush by using the slider on the left. And you can also change the opacity using the slider underneath. To undo an action, you just double tap with two fingers. Or you can use the back button on the left hand side. So I'm going to grab a brush from my custom brushes. These are the ones I've created. You can grab them on Creative Market as well as Etsy. I'll leave links below. So I'm just going to grab the fat ink brush. That's the one I use to draw out my name here. And I'm just gonna draw a heart. Actually, I want it to be a bit thicker, so I'm gonna increase the size. It's a bit too thick. Okay, so now I've drawn a heart. So you can, if you find that there's some settings to the brush you don't like, if you just tap once, you're able to go in here and change those settings. But you don't want to play around with the original settings in case you mess something up. So the best way to do that is slide over to the left and click duplicate. They don't change the name. They don't add a copy to the end. So if I were you, I would rename that quickly so you can remember what's the original and what's the new one. And then from here, you can change a whole bunch of things, the shape. You can add some grain, you can change the max size, you want it to be bigger. So all of those things will make a different brush. So for your layers, I have three layers here. There's different things you can do if you want to, control all of the layers at once. You can put them in a group. There's a few ways you can add them into a group. You can do that by selecting this one and then selecting this. And you can select this by swiping to the right. So now they're all selected. So you can hit this icon at the top right. The other way to group layers is by selecting one, holding, and then dragging it into another layer. This will automatically create the group. So there's two ways of doing that. And now in this group, you can make the item bigger as one whole group. You're not able to do any of the adjustment settings for a whole group, but there's a few things you can do, and it's a good way of keeping your workspace tidy. You can also merge layers. I'm just going to ungroup this. You merge layers in two ways. One is you can grab them together and pinch them, or you can just tap and then choose merge down. It's pretty hard to merge two layers when they're right beside each other. It worked this time, but generally I can do that for like 5 minutes and still never be able to merge them. So to make it easy, you can just select merge down and it'll merge into one. Another cool thing, you can copy the contents of a layer and use it somewhere else. So you can just click copy and then open notes, paste, and then there it is. Okay, the next thing I'm going to show you are the colors. There's a few ways to change the color of a layer. You can select the layer and then choose the color you want. So I'm just going to go to pink over here. And now if you want to view more detail of this color, you can just pinch and zoom and you have more range of that color. So just move it around, choose that color. Then you can drag the color over to your type and then you have the color change. Another cool thing is if you're using two colors consistently, you can just press and hold and it's going to go back to the color you had before. Another way to change the colors, if you go into your layers, you're going to add an alpha. You used to be able to swipe to the right and it would appear, but they've changed that in the updates. You want to swipe to the right with two fingers, and now you'll see that there is a pattern, this kind of transparent grid. So the alpha lock is on. Now if you choose a different color, grab your paintbrush and then just draw over top, you'll see that it only changes the color within those pixels. So it's a great way to get precise, kind of like filling in the lines. So to take the alpha lock off, just swipe to the right again, and there you go. Another cool way to change the color is if you go into adjustments and hit hue, saturation, brightness. You can change the color here. However, mine is black, so I'm just going to grab my color picker, fill it out there, and go to hue, saturation, brightness. Change saturation, you can change the color. It's kind of a neat way to view a whole bunch of different colors if you're not sure which color to use in your project. And you can make it lighter or darker. So that's another way to change the colors. If you're working on a project, say, that is branded with colors and you want to be able to save the colors to use on different projects or send to a coworker or someone else that you're working with, you can. So you select the color wheel, and then here you can see I have one already started. So if you just select this arrow, you're taking to all of your palettes. So you can create a new palette by just hitting the plus button, and you can rename it just by tapping and type in new palette. So now that one's selected. So if you go back, you have that here. So to add one of these colors to the palette, I'm just going to zoom out so we have the full color wheel. You just hit the box and then the color shows up there. If you don't want the color there anymore, just double tap and hit delete. So I'm going to add that back. Another cool thing you can do with a palette, so if you are working with another person on a project, you can swipe to the left and hit share, and then you can share that color palette with anyone. If you don't want to find colors using the color wheel, you can just select the hamburger menu over on the top left. And then here you can find colors either by RGB or hex codes. Another way to find colors is by the color picker. So if you just grab this, you have the magnifying glass here and you can just select where you want the color and then it chooses the color for you. Okay, so now I'm going to show you some of the textures and blend modes, and to do that I'm going to import a photo. So from the toolbar, I'm going to go insert flat image. I'm going to choose photos, and I have a folder here with high-res images. So I'm going to select this image. So it puts the image on the topmost layer. So to move that down, I'm just going to grab it, hold it, and pull it down to the bottom. It actually put it in a group, but anyways. So I'm going to resize this image. You can see there's some space above and below. To do that, I'm going to make sure the image is selected. I'm going to hit the arrow, and then I'm just going to pull it open using my fingers. It's on freeform right now, so it may not be exact, but you can change that by selecting magnetic, and this way it will keep all the proportions when you open it. Okay, so I'm just going to change this back to black. And now I'm going to change the blend mode of these text layers. So you can see there's an N icon to the right. If you just select that, you get all the different blend modes similar to Photoshop. You can change the opacity here, and then the way that it blends here. So I'm going to choose overlay. And then to make it even more contrast, I'm going to duplicate it so it's double. So it's there, you can see that. So I'm going to choose the photo, go to the adjustments menu, and then choose, let's do Gaussian blur. So there's a slider on the top, you just go like this to change the blur. You can do motion blur as well. So there's some cool effects up in the adjustments bar here. You have to also sharpen, noise, and perspective. Okay, so I'm going to show you how to use the selection tool. Make sure you've chosen the layer you want to select, then choose the S ribbon. You have freehand and automatic. I'm going to show you how to use both. First, try the automatic, and then just tap on the screen. You can see now that it's selected everything around this. So I'm going to invert that so it actually selects the inside of the heart. And then you'll see that it also includes this middle part. So now I'm going to choose the freehand tool, and then I'm just going to go in here and grab the area I need. It's pretty messy the way I did it, but just to show you, then you hit minus. So now it's, you can see the areas that have the grid are the ones that are not selected, and then these ones are selected. So now I'm going to fill that with the white. And you can see where it filled, and those are the areas that I missed. So let's get out of the selection tool. And then if you want to bring that selection tool back up, you can just tap and hold the selection, and the last selection you made comes back up automatically. So you can actually change the mask here if you'd like. You can go into preferences, and then selection mask visibility is 25%, so we can just crank that up to, let's say, 67%. So let's just tap and hold to bring the selection up again. Now you can see it's a lot darker. So I prefer this because it's a little bit easier to see the spots that you've missed. So if I go into freehand now, I can just go here and then clean it up. So then I'll just hit, finish that loop, and then hit add, although that was a mistake, so you can hit back, and then I'll just go minus. Another cool thing that Procreate has is the ability to view your work as you make progress, and also to share that work. So to share your video, there are a couple ways. You can do a progress video that shows what you did from the very beginning with every step, or you can choose when you'd like to do a screen capture. So if you go into your toolbar here and you go to video, you can do start screen capture. And you can choose if you want to have just the screen or the screen plus a video of whatever the camera is seeing. So I'm just going to do record screen only. And then from in here, you can turn on your microphone or your camera. So I'm going to turn off the microphone. And then I'm going to show you an example. So I'm going to hit a new layer. Okay, so then you can hit stop recording. And it brings up the file automatically. And you just play it back. And it shows you exactly everything you did right after you hit start recording. So to see your progress from the very beginning to the end, you just go in here and you click time-lapse replay. So that's pretty fun to see where you started and where you ended. Okay, so here's a bonus tip. If you go into the menu preferences and then you go into advanced gesture controls, quick menu is probably deselected. So turn that on and you're gonna find there's a faster way to get your work done. You can also choose how you'd like to pull this up. I have touch chosen, it's the default. So now when you're in your work, you can just tap and a new menu comes up. This one was a little bit over to the side. Basically, you can just select one of those items instead of going in to here and choosing a new menu. You can also tap and then choose this and just hold for a bit longer, and then you get even more actions for this main one.
Hopefully this helps you get started with Procreate. If you learned something new, give this video a like and subscribe for new tutorials.